Visualizing quantitative UX data is critical for sharing that data with colleagues, stakeholders, leadership, or clients. You should design your charts the same way that you would design a product, with your goal and your audience in mind. In this three-part series, we'll consider some ways to make your charts clear and easy to understand. When you begin to design a chart, one of the first choices you'll have to make is which chart type you'll use. For most UX purposes, I recommend sticking with the basics: bar charts, line charts, or scatter plots. There are some very rare situations where you might use less common chart types, like bubble or mosaic charts. However, in the vast majority of situations, I really recommend avoiding these. Researchers have found that they require people to visually assess angle, area, or volume to understand the data, and that is a lot of cognitive work for people to do. Let's talk about each of the three chart types that I do recommend, and when you might use each one. First, bar charts. These are a classic for a reason. They're typically easy for people to process and understand, and they work well for many UX visualizations. For example, this simple bar chart shows the different conversion rates before and after a redesign, with the goal of communicating the redesign's success. Bar charts can also be used to show two data series side by side in what's called a paired bar chart. As an example, let's imagine that we recently redesigned a website that sells home furniture. We have two primary user groups: people who buy furniture for their own homes, consumers, and people who buy furniture for their clients, interior designers. We collect the average order value for each group before and after the redesign. Essentially, this number shows how much money we make from the average purchase. This is a great opportunity for a paired bar chart. However, we have a choice to make. Do we group the bars by time, so before versus after, or do we group them by user group, consumers versus interior designers? It might feel logical to group the bars by time so that you have the before values together and the after values together. However, that would be a mistake in this case. We have to think about our goal. What comparison do we want people to make? Then we want to put those things close together so that our viewers can easily see them side by side. In this chart, the easiest comparison is between the user groups. It essentially shows that professionals buy more than the amateurs. But that really isn't the point that we're trying to make here. Instead, we want people to compare the before and after values for each user group. So, if we group the bars by user group, then our viewers can easily move their eyes between the before and after values for each group to easily understand the difference. The takeaway now underscores that this redesign had the biggest impact on the average order value of the interior designers. Next up, line charts. If you want to show a data trend over time, a line chart will work better than a bar chart. If you do create line charts, be sure to use data point markers to clarify where in the timeline you collected the data. This example shows the trend of one company's CSAT scores over a 5-year period. Each data marker, shown by a blue dot, indicates when the data was collected. Finally, scatter plots. These can work in situations where you want to show the relationship between two variables. Scatter plots look like line charts, but the points are not connected with lines. So, for example, to show that a few of the features in an app are used most frequently by the majority of users, we might show each feature as a dot plotted against the percentage of accounts that use each feature, which is the x-axis, and the average amount of times that the feature is used by each user in a month, which is the y-axis. This example might be useful to argue for prioritizing these three most popular features. Think carefully about which chart type you'll choose and make sure it serves the point that you're trying to communicate. That's the first step in creating clear and understandable charts.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more of our UX videos, take a look at these over here and consider subscribing to our channel. On our website, nngroup.com, you can access our free library of over 2,000 articles. You can also register for one of our virtual UX conferences that offer live hands-on UX training.